Yeah, Robert Milkins, he said Rishi there, he fancies his bag as Bob. Ideally suited to this environment.
Yes, and he's played in every one flame shootout there's been. It's in its eighth year. So he's picked up quite a bit about how to play the format.
Yeah, I had a chat with him after his win earlier on today, and he said he was incredibly nervous, but then, I suppose when you think about it, every snooker player's nervous every time they play in a match, so no change there. It's how you cope with it.
Cagey opening, 2 minutes without a ball potted.
Yeah, now he's going to have to play some sort of shot here, Hamza. No roll-up, obviously, so got to play this with a little bit extra pace, make sure he hits a cushion. Just made it. Feeling. I know he'll take it on, that sort of player.
Wilkins has got eagles.
Four.
With natural ability.
Five.
Just very natural in the way. He sights up a shot, gets straight into his stance, and with the minimum of preliminaries, he fires.
Twelve.
One of those players as well in the game. He uses his cues an absolute caber, like an iron rod. Really bashes through the ball, almost bullies them in. Does have an exquisite 20. Touch as well when it's needed.
There's 21.
Example of it there. He just looked to the heavens because the red at the back, he just pushed it beyond the other red. It doesn't go. So it's a red on the balk line he's going to play for. Times that player misses a simple-ish black because his eyes on the pack that he's playing into. Not the first time, it certainly won't be the last. The disappointment almost of not having the red at the back of the cluster to play on is partly the reason he missed it. Table this one, even though he's at the table still, he needs at least another red and high value colour to hit the front. There's only two of those reds at present. you see it's still seven behind pink and 14. Black out of commission, so still looking for two more reds to at least tie. That'll do nicely, straight blue.
15.
Perfect angle on it, nothing to do with the cue ball. Quite hit it though. Not the tallest player, I think he just about reached this. Can it?
20.
Yeah. That's running down. Pressure in this. And he didn't cope with it.
So, only one in.
20.
3.5 minutes to go. Fast and furious action was promised in the one-frame shootout. But there's plenty of scope for tactical play.
Now, has he got cover with a yellow? If he has, it's an excellent shot. The situation of the frame is pretty straightforward here. Hamza Akbar, barring a foul from Bob, is going to have to pot something in the next 2.5 minutes. Often you see Robert Milkins on the defensive, but that's what's going to be happening for the remainder of this frame.
And did you see Akbar's bridge arm quivering as he played that shot?
Simple pressure. Crazy, but he'd probably be as well putting the blue in the side cushion here. That would mean Bob would need two reds, two colours, black and pink as they are, but nah, that's just maybe being ultra defensive. So a 10-point lead, less than a minute.
Into the last 40 seconds.
Yeah, do not under any circumstances go for a pot here, Hamza. That's a good shot.
That was Milkins' last chance. He recognises it by offering his hand. With 11 seconds still to play, so Hamza Akbar is into the third round, the last 32.